grace to God. Three rock stars, nobody seeing the gang on guard.
God.
All right, Coach, we are pleased as always to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Baltimore Ravens and the New York Jets. The first quarter of the season already in the rearview mirror, and off we go in week 5 on EA Sports. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Here on first down. Wide open receiver complete. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. A big play there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Ravens have taken the early lead. Tucker with the extra point. And that makes the score 7-0. Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Try the right side here. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. The success there, Charles, coming on the outside of the field, the ground game. Curious to see if that continues as we progress.
Yeah, we often talk about a variety in play calling, and usually between run and pass. In this case, with strictly the run game, you can be creative there as well. Run it inside, run it outside, keep the defense off balance.
He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2. The 38. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
Well, that was big right there because they're in the bottom 5 in the league and converting on 3rd down. They needed that pickup in a big way.
There were 2 things they said they wanted to win in this game. One, the turnover battle, and the second, 3rd down conversions. So they got one there. Now a handoff looking right. Looking to find a lane, but he can't, reined in at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. 2nd down.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Watch him now, Barney. Barney. Hot. Hot.
On the ground, this is Lamar Miller. And here's another tackle made at the line. So they're converging well on the football now. The linebacker, C.J. Mosley, in on the stop.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
So a third and 10, and defensively, a dime look, six DBs. They'll set up a throw. And Jeffrey's got it. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first. Toss. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
Absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be third and 10 now. Looking to throw. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. That goes for a gain of 31.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. They know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and then hold down their production. But I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
Gone, gone! Gone, gone! Over, over! Over, over!
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And he goes down. The Ravens able to get to him. Jordan Willis in there to sack him for a loss of 6.
Enough takes a start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
No, now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
The Jets on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is going to be third and 13. To throw. And he's got it. And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. In for the score. And the Jets are an extra point away from tying this thing up.
And that drive we just saw that culminated in a touchdown, exactly what many offenses are looking for. Sustained ones that can impose their will on the other team.
And it's no good. He misses the extra point, and this remains a 7-6 game. Now the punter, who also does the kickoff duties, Locke Edwards, out to kick it away.
That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Ravens offense now, they get set to head back on the field. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was real easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here.
Here we go.
They go play action here on first down. Dancing to his left. Throw left side complete. It's Hall. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 23 yards on the play.
And let's face it, that what we just saw there, not a surprise, is it? I mean, this is what he does well. And if you don't tackle him as soon as he catches the ball, this is the end result. Big yardage afterwards.
Got the speed, the agility, so good with run after catch. And we're only in the first quarter, so they better get a wrangle and a hold on that quickly.
Yeah, you're exactly right. And what's really difficult to try and defend him is if you want to press him so that you get him on the ground quickly after the catch, a lot of times he'll just run past you at the initial point of contact, and he'll go deep.
Back to throw now on first down. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And incomplete. He dropped it in the end zone. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10.
Detroit! Detroit!
They'll look to throw here. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off with great anticipation. And he will bring it out past the 20-yard line. And the young buck, the rookie, just racked up his first career interception.
And how about the scouting department? They've got to be very happy right now because in NFL parlance, he's a third-day selection. Anyone after the fourth round? That's big-time scouting right there, and what a great play he just made.
And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11.
Watch it now, Barney.
Back to throw here. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. But I think a jet was able to recover, and they'll keep possession thanks to a heads-up play.
On plays like this, when the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. Usually,
and it's intercepted. Marcus May with a pick, and they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
Well, Brandon, there's no question who's that as well, so they've got him blanketed downfield, and this ball winds up being intercepted.
Gone, 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 gone.
Here's the first carry for Tariq Cohen. And he's going to get this inside the 30. It's a pickup of 11 at a Baltimore first down.
At this stage of the game, the run pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
And they'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. A great play there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Ravens will extend their lead. Tucker able to connect on the extra point. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful.
Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. And this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. So out now come the Jets. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more confident?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here.
And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. So the loss of a yard, and now second and 11 from the 24-yard line. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Caught right side is Jeffrey. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down.
No. Check. Patriot.
They'll look to throw now on first down. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one.
Hurry up, here we go. 3-19.
Now back to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Deion Buchanan coming hard on the blitz. He dumps him for a loss of 8.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been on constant duress this entire game. I'm the guy surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game.
His first catch there, good for 10 yards and a first down.
When an offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because they should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback. A hot route, so to speak.
And nearly picked off. Surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away, but it does get away and it's second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Again, he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down. The Jets on third down. They have been superb. 5 for 6 to this point. This is third and 10.
Watch it now, Barney.
They'll set up to throw. He's going to rifle one deep left side, and he can't hang on to it. Nearly picked. He's known for his hands defensively, but instead it just brings up fourth down. On fourth down, here's Lachlan Edwards to punt it. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. So 1:55 to go in the first half. We'll come back to MetLife Stadium after this short timeout. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down.
Now let's go. 3-19. 3-19. Watch it now, Barney. Gun.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. And the Jets pressure too much as down he goes. The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. They'll look to throw. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Going with a dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue 90! Blue 90!
He'll look to throw. He's going to look deep for Perriman. And got his man complete. And he takes it all the way down to the 32. A big-time third down play for the Ravens. 52 yards. They'll look to throw here on first down. And he's going to go down here. A sack. They push him back to the 34. Leonard Williams able to get in there and drop him for a 2-yard loss. They'll come up after the sack on a 2nd and 12.
Now let's go. Blue 90. Blue 90. Leppard. Leppard. Hut.
He'll drop to throw. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Darren Lee in there to drop him, and sacks on first and second downs are going to lead to a third and long. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long.
Green 39! Green 39!
Back to throw. Looking deep downfield. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining. And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. They'll look to throw. Pass the 20. Over the middle, complete. That's Hall. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. First red zone chance now for the Ravens. First and 10 at the 19. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. And that is caught. But the back judge right there to say incomplete. And that is off target to the right. Never had a chance. Not even close. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. This clearly the final play of the half. But no field goal attempt. They're going for it with 3 seconds remaining. They'll throw now on the final play. Got a man, it's caught for a Ravens touchdown. As his guys are in for 6, and the Ravens will add on to their lead. You knew time was going to run out, so this had to be in the end zone, and somehow they were able to find a window and get it done.
Very easy for us to talk about up here that, yes, all that had to happen. But when time's running down, sometimes your brain compresses a little bit too. They show great poise, understanding of situation, making sure they get to the end zone in order to complete that pass and take a nice momentum into the locker room.
This one taken from the 7. And out of bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. And the Jets set to take the field. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a real,
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. And he'll wind up with about six up past the 30 to the 31.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
They'll come up now, second and four from the 31. They're going to look to throw. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Jordan Willis in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. On third down, he'll drop to throw. He'll rifle this one deep right side, and he can't hang on to it. Nearly picked. He's known for his hands defensively, but instead it just brings up fourth down. Here's Lachlan Edwards now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. And it's fielded at the 34. That'll go as a 39-yard punt, give him nine on the return. And the Ravens, they'll take over. The Ravens offense getting ready now for their first possession of the second half. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? I mean, they score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, the fact you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
Going for the deep ball. And that is incomplete, but a penalty flag is down. This could possibly be a push-off. Looked like some hands both ways. They got it on the offense.
Sometimes there's a fine line between being the receiver and the DB, and he knocked that one away. Might have caused an incompletion that could have been an interception.
Hurry up, here we go.
On play action, they'll throw. They'll be taken down. The Jets get in there for the sack. Za'Darius Smith coming on the blitz. He gets him for a loss of seven. After the sack, oh, they're staring at a challenge basically from the other side of town. It's second and a country mile. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Smith catches left side. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
Throw. He'll leave it for Cohen, complete. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down. The Ravens send their punter out now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. This is fielded at the 27. Now a hit and a loose football.
And that's what friends are for.
Right. As the returner, you know who you're buying dinner for later.
Oh, without a doubt, because he just took care of you and your team in a big way. You know, you turned it over there. That's a big momentum changer and put your defense in a bad spot.
Didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped to the backfield. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Well, if these guys are going to chop into that deficit, they're going to have to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage will be found.
So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards.
They'll drop the throw. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
They'll set up a throw. He's going to fire one deep. Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Tavon Young. And what a return as he brings this one all the way back to the 25-yard line.
Well, it's third and long, and you've got a few different ways to play it offensively. But this is not the type of offense that's going to wave the white flag. They're going to keep chucking it. And this time, it results in an interception.
Yardage back at the 27. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Well, you had to punt on your first drive, and on the first play of the second drive, you end up going backwards. I would dare say they need something good to happen right here, right now.
Now let's go. Green 39. Green 39.
They try again with Cohen, and he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. They'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Looking to throw. He's going to air one out. And this is going to be intercepted. Good positioning, and it's picked off.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
Shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness of that defensive line is eating them alive.
Got to imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18.
Gun!
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. From the left side, it's complete. And he'll be taken down, but they've got this one up to the 35-yard line. 23 yards on the play. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And a quick throw here, that's complete. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. That throw good for four. It's second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
The jet passing game in rhythm. They've got another first. He'll look to throw. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Anthony Averett picks it, and the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. A really good pickup of 28 yards. They go play action here on first down. Wide open receiver, complete. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. 23 yards on the play. This quarterback now, five straight completions here in this second half, first and 10.
Hurry up, here we go. Green.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. It's caught, Smith. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off, okay? So they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication, and as he dragged the clock.
And he'll go down, brought down at the 20-yard line.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Gone, gone, gone.
They'll look to throw here. And it's caught. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. And he's top five in the league in terms of receiving yardage because of plays like that. What have you seen from him on film that you like so much?
Well, I'll strip away everything else and get to what we call the moment of truth. When the ball's arriving and there's a defender there, he just comes down with the ball. He competes and takes it away. Great hands, great ability to finish the catch.
And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal.
Now let's go. Green 39. Green 39.
Oh, how about this call down near the goal line? And he'll get in. Touchdown, Baltimore. In for the score. And the Ravens will extend their lead. Now Tucker to add the PAT. Touchdown. Tucker with the extra point. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And New York set to take the field. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Detroit! Detroit!
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Herndon's got it complete. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
We got three down. Hey, fellas, we got three. Let's go.
Back 99, Philly. Here we go.
Now back to throw. And it's caught by Herndon. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That's good for a Jet first down, a gain of 13. They'll look to throw now on first down. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8. They'll look to throw again. And he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here. We have not seen a whole lot of wide-open receivers. Everything seemingly has been contested.
And that's another nice job there to force an incompletion. They've been very cohesive, knowing each other's moves all game long, and they've been on the spot just about every time.
And they've held them in check on the scoreboard.
Watch it now, Barney! Barney! Hot!
Hot! He'll drop to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football, and it's picked up by the Ravens. And he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line.
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely.
Here we go now. Green, 39.
Now a play fake here on first down. This is caught. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. 18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal. And he's certainly been a huge factor in this one. He's got the two touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him? Double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove and such a connection, it doesn't matter how many guys are in his area.
He certainly looks to be in that groove right now. Oh, how about this on first and goal? And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. And while that's his second rushing touchdown, third total, he did have the receiving TD earlier.
He creates a matchup nightmare all the time, doesn't he? If you pull everyone in trying to stop him running the ball, split him out or get him out of the backfield and throw the ball to him, he can hurt you either way. Very, very well.
Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Jets offensive unit ready to get going here. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over. The other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
They're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. Now they'll run it on the toss. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. That'll wind up going for a loss of 4. And it'll bring up a 2nd and 14. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway.
Four down, four
time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. Attack here, and he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So their move is to decline that so they don't get another second down. It'll be third.
So that has to tell us that they're pretty confident in their third down defense, right?
Absolutely.
Whether it's their sub package or nickel package, whatever they want to run out there, they feel like they can defend here on third down.
And this third down looking very tough after the holding penalty. Third and long. Back to throw. Hard throw, incomplete.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback, but when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps to have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
Here's Lachlan Edwards now as he's on to punt for New York. And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. It'll be called just a 22-yard punt, certainly not what he wanted. And the Ravens set up well to begin their drive as it'll begin in enemy territory already. Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field. They have the big cushion here in the final stages of this one. I don't know if there's any better feeling than being up big on the road.
There really can't be, because for a team to go on the road and win in the
NFL,
that's huge to begin with. But just think about all the preparation that went into it when they first started talking about this game.
And he will be hit from behind and run over. Wow. Leonard Williams in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year. So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. Now it looks like he'll throw here. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. But it looked like a Raven was able to get in there, and they will indeed keep the possession. So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah, that stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but the other team doesn't get it. That's a huge difference in the ball game. And in this case, they were able to retain possession.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. He's going to float this one deep right side. And that is caught one-handed. Oh, my, he pulled it in. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. A big play there. 67 yards. And the Ravens add on. Tucker now to add the point after. Tucker able to connect on the... Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Jets offense now works their way back onto the field. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this, and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and nine from the 26. They run a draw here on second down. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down.
Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on 3rd and 6. Shot. They'll look to throw underneath for Miller. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying,